Monday started out very slow. My son was expecting a package from UPS, and I had to stick around and sign for it. I took advantage of this time to get some editing done. I was falling way behind. So after the package had arrived, I stuck around the house all afternoon, continuing to edit to try to get the first video out. I didn't start dashing until later on in the evening after taking Daniel some food for dinner. Actually, forgot that I scheduled myself to dash. Only 2 hours. There's probably going to be no Walmart Spark tonight. But as soon as I turned on the Dasher app, I got an order for dogs. Sorry, I didn't pay attention to the miles. But it's popping off already. Not even 30 seconds. Take a chance that maybe it's done 2 minutes early. Finally got it, but I am on pay by time, so it doesn't really matter. There was a time when diesel was cheaper than regular gasoline, many moons ago. It was a very short night. I only did that one DoorDash order, and I did one Walmart trip that had two orders in it. So the breakdown is on DoorDash for Monday, I made $14.32 on Walmart Spark, I made $15.82 for a total of $30.14. That is a far cry from $100, but I had obstacles like waiting on a package and not starting to dash till late in the day. Good morning, guys. Another beautiful morning. Even though we had some rain, it was much needed rain. I got a dilemma. My doggy figured out how to get into my blueberries. One of our blueberry bushes is leaning over. My son is going to be pissed. But I got a bungee cord to try to keep that little gate closed. I don't know if you can see that or not. But say good morning, Dutton. Dutton, puppy. There's my puppy. Oh, look, what a pretty boy. Is he so photogenic or what? Part of this dilemma is when I was trying to fix that little opening, I had a brick there, well, one of them cinder blocks. I dropped it on my foot. So my foot's not feeling so great. Somebody just wrecked their jet heating, not paying attention to the branches. He just wrecked the tree. And that's our tree. Okay, we are gonna be turning on our apps. I may even try to turn on Uber Eats. I'm turning on Walmart Spark. And we are gonna see if DoorDash is available yet either. When I was scheduling myself, I was only able to schedule myself for one dash today. So I'm gonna take advantage of that. Yesterday just plain out sucked, but of course I got a lot of editing done. Today the game plan is I'm going to work all morning between Walmart Spark and DoorDash from 11:30 till 1:30. Go to the grocery store, grab a couple things, go home. I really need to start some organization, cleaning up my kitchen and stuff. And I'm actually going to cook dinner tonight. I'm thinking I'm going to make spaghetti. That way he can take spaghetti with him tomorrow. I have a lot of DoorDashing that I'm doing tomorrow. But I will see you when I get an order. I just got an order from Walmart, but let me see. There's also an incentive going on from 6:20 to 6:26. Got it. Okay, let's see what this order is. Start shopping at 9:25 a.m. 4.4 miles for $23. 26 items. I'm gonna take that. Finished it up. It took me an hour to shop that order because it had me all over the store. I was hunting for items, having to chat the customer for what, a $2 tip. Live and learn. Okay, I'm gonna go get this delivered. DoorDash is still dead. I'm scheduled to dash in about 40 minutes. That Walmart order took me over an hour. It shouldn't have taken me that long. However, in my defense, it was my first shop and deliver order. So, okay. I'm heading back, and I had that offer that I got on Walmart that came in. It was a batch order, 6 orders, and it was coming out of Brownsville again. I'm not doing that. Well, I've got Uber Eats on, I've got Walmart on. I can't dash now. The map is gray. And Walmart keeps sending the same batched order from Brownsville. 6 orders for $29 and some change for 31 miles. And 31 miles is starting at the Brownsville Walmart. It's not taken into account. I've got 14 miles to drive to get there. I keep rejecting. They keep sending it back. I'm assuming it's happening to other drivers as well. GoPros. Well, I had a DoorDash order come in. It was for just under $7. For 6 miles. Well, I'm going to pick that up. That was at a Pizza Hut. I ended up dropping that order because Uber Eats actually chimed in at a $17.95 order. It's for about 10 miles. The dollar per mile ratio is better. And is that my favorite Dairy Queen? This Dairy Queen, I'll be there in 10 minutes. I accidentally had start delivery by mistake, but they actually gave me a drink that this Dairy Queen always does. That's why I love it. I just got an offer for $7.75 on DoorDash. Pick up at Wendy's. I don't like the miles. However, right now, orders are slim pickings. It's like just under 7 miles. Thank you. What's Wendy's giving away today? Okay, I got this Walmart trip. I paused my dash. It is $14.47. The mileage, I forget what it is, but it is not bad at all. It's only like maybe 4 miles, I think. 7.6 miles, there we go. And it says it's ready, but pickup time is 12:45, is 12:37. I'm gonna try a little trick here in a minute to see if it'll let me check in early. And the item count, by the way, the items are not bad. There's not very many on here, nothing super heavy. I didn't record the pickup, I should have. You would have seen all the bags of the chips that this person got. Keep right onto Rustraver Road. It was just overwhelming. Somebody got the munchy munchies. Okay, I did not record that drop-off because it's at a daycare. However, so that's where, who has the munchies, little munchkins getting the munchies. Thank you. This was a very slow day in my market. Didn't make a whole lot of moolah. On DoorDash, I only made $7.75. On Uber Eats, I made $17.04. And on Walmart Spark is the winner for the day, I had made $30.81 for a grand total of the day of $55.60. That's pretty sad. But considering I only got in a couple hours, I want to keep these videos shorter. So this is it for episode 3, and I will see you in the next one.